that the testimony you give this jury will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
Yes.
Thank you. Please feel free to have a seat. Ms. Frain, as we're being recorded here today, would you please state your first and your last name for the record and spell them out for us?
Kimberly, K-I-M-B-E-R-L-Y, Frain, F-R-A-I-N.
All right. Thank you, Ms. Frain. Appreciate that. With regards to New Hampshire, do you live in the state?
Yes.
Okay. And generally, what town do you live in?
Meredith.
In Meredith. And what are you doing for work right now?
I'm working in healthcare at a hospital.
Okay. And how long have you been doing that?
Almost 3 years.
How far have you gone in school?
I'm actually back in school now.
Oh, what are you studying?
Where?
What? I'm sorry, what are you studying?
It's kind of long. Healthcare administration.
Okay. And how long have you been, or how long do you have to go before you get a degree?
Like 3 more years.
3 more years?
Yeah.
All right. Pardon me. So I'm going to ask just one question at a time, so I'd ask you to please listen carefully to either my question or any other counsel's question that you get asked. And if I'm talking too quickly or if you don't understand my question, just let me know. I'll be happy to restate it, okay?
Okay.
All right. Thanks. Prior to where you live now, did you used to live in Manchester back in 2019?
Yes.
All right. And do you know of somebody by the name of Adam Montgomery?
Yes.
Did you ever used to work at a Dunkin' Donuts on Beach Street in Manchester?
Yes.
How long did you work there?
Like 5 years.
About 5 years?
Maybe.
Okay. Let me ask, you also know the name Kayla Montgomery?
Yes.
And what was when you, and have you met Kayla Montgomery?
Yes.
Right. What's the relationship between Kayla Montgomery and Adam Montgomery when you first met them?
I met them at work. We worked together. First, I worked with Kayla, and then Adam worked with us, too.
With regards to Kayla and Adam, did you ever meet Adam's daughter, Harmony Montgomery?
Once.
One time?
Yes.
All right. Did you ever spend time with her?
Yes. I babysat her and the two boys, or one boy at the time, at my house.
At your house?
Yeah.
And would this have been back in 2019?
Yeah, I think it was the summer of 2019.
I'd like to ask some specific questions for you about Adam Montgomery, specifically about beginning in the winter of that year at the end of 2019, all right?
Okay.
Right. Did you ever bring Adam Montgomery jumper cables to try to start a car?
Yes.
How many times have you done that for him?
Once.
Just the one time?
One time.
How did he reach out to you for help?
He either called me or it was on Facebook. I can't remember which. And he said that their car had died and it was freezing out and they wanted me to come jump start their car. And I told them no, but they kept begging and I felt bad. So I went.
Okay. So you said maybe the messaged you or reached out on Facebook. Is that right? Did you have a Facebook account at one point that just went by the name Kimberly Frain?
Yeah.
And is that the account that he might have messaged you on?
Yeah.
What time was this? What time of morning was this that Adam reached out, or you got these messages asking for a jump?
It was in the middle of the night. I just remember that. It was late.
So did you go to where they were and give them a jump?
I did.
Where did you go?
It's behind Elm Street in, I think it's Colonial Apartments.
Okay. And is that at the south side of town, west side, or north side of town?
It's like right down the road from my house on the north side.
Okay. When you saw them, do you remember what kind of car they were in at that night?
Yeah, they were in a blue Audi.
Now, when you went to meet them, first of all, what was the weather like that night?
It was cold. It was freezing.
So when you got there, who, if anybody, got into your car?
I pulled up, and I don't remember the beginning, but I don't think I brought a jumper pack mm-hmm. that my ex-husband had, and a good Samaritan came by, and him and Adam jump-started it, and Kayla jumped in my car with the two boys, and we just blasted the heat. keep them warm.
To keep them warm?
Yeah.
So you said it was Kayla and the two boys?
Two boys.
Okay. So I know you said before that you had babysat Harmony on one occasion. Was Harmony there with you? Did she get into the car as well with Kayla and the two boys?
No.
Did you see Harmony at all while you were there that night?
No.
And I believe you said a Good Samaritan came along. Do you remember who that is or even know who that is?
No, it was just somebody in the complex saw us struggling.
Okay. I'll ask this one other question. After that one time, did you ever jump a car for them again?
No. Okay. I was distancing myself from them.
Do you remember the exact day that this occurred in the winter of 2019, end of 2019?
I don't.
Okay. Just that it was very cold out, is that right?
Yeah.
All right. Just a moment, please, Your Honor. Thank you, Your Honor, and thank you, Ms. Frain. I have one more question just for you in general. With regards to conversations that you've had with Adam Montgomery, the defendant in this case, with regards to the conversations, did you ever have a conversation with him about Harmony having bathroom accidents or wetting herself or defecating herself in her pants?
I don't think so. Not him.
Not him?
No.
Okay. With anybody else?
Maybe with Kayla, but I don't remember exactly. Okay.
Well, and I don't want you to guess. So if you remember, you remember. If you don't, you don't. That's okay. And so you're saying your testimony is you don't.
I don't remember.
All right. All right. Thank you very much for your time. I have no further questions for you. I believe defense counsel may have a few.
Thank you.
Counsel, you want to move? Come up.
Yes, Your Honor.
Go ahead.
Good afternoon, and I only have a couple of questions.
Okay.
You recalled that whatever car that you jumped, you thought it was a blue Audi?
Yeah.
And you know from before that Adam used to drive a Sebring?
It was a silver car.
Okay. This was not the car that Adam used to drive around, right? And you remembered this way back in 2021 when the police first asked you about it, right?
Yeah.
And your memory, even the first time you talked about it, was a blue Sebring. Blue Audi.
No, I think I might have told them the other. I think I told them it was the silver car, but okay. it was the Audi they were in.
Okay, so you're really clear about that, huh?
Yeah.
So what changed when you first said the Sebring and then sort of recalled the Audi?
I just couldn't remember the time frames because it was so long ago.
Okay. So I understand that, but what changed your recollection of the type of car?
Objection, Your Honor, has been answered at this point.
Overruled. Go ahead.
I'm sorry.
Okay. I think you said at first you told him it was the Sebring, but then the blue Audi when they first started questioning you on it, right?
Yeah.
Do you know what it was that made you say that it was the blue Audi?
No.
Okay. Thank you.
Anything further? You may step down. Counsel approach.